Hello friends, in this video we are going to understand one of the important concepts of TV signal transmission is nothing but the vestigial sideband. How the vestigial sideband is get formed and how it is transmitted by using a television system. So let's begin with the topic. In the topic of vestigial sideband, first we are going to understand the fundamentals of vestigial sideband. In video signal, the low frequency modulated components are present along with the rest of the signal. So these low frequency modulated component results into the formation of sideband, that is called as lower sideband. So here it is mentioned that in video signal, the low frequency modulating component results into the sideband, which are very close to the carrier frequency. As they are very close to the carrier frequency, therefore it is very much difficult to remove this low frequency modulated component. And therefore, designing of filter for removing such type of low frequency modulated component becomes difficult. So these low frequency component contain most of the important information about the video signal. And suppressing one complete sideband is not possible in case of video signal, because the lower component of the video signal or low frequency or video signal consists of most important information about the video signal. Therefore, as a compromise, partial part of the lower sideband is get suppressed and remaining part is get added with the full USB, and that is called as vestigial sideband. So now we can say that if the lower side component or low frequency component in the TV transmission system is get removed, then it causes distortion in the output or the distortion in the reproduced picture, and that can be seen as a damage in the reproduced picture. So as a compromise, only small portion or only some part of the lower sideband is get suppressed and remaining portion is get added with the full USB. So the transmitted signal now consists of full USB, that is full upper sideband, along with remaining portion which is not suppressed by the filter, that portion is get added with the USB along with the carrier signal. This pattern of signal transmission is called as vestigial sideband transmission, or it is also called as A5C transmission. Now in 625 line system, which is a European line system or European standard for television, the frequencies up to 0.75 megahertz in lower sideband are fully radiated. So from the total 625 line, the frequencies above 0.75 megahertz are get suppressed, and the frequencies up to 0.75 megahertz are get radiated by using a vestigial sideband transmission. So because of this, it results into normal double sideband transmission for lower video frequencies corresponds to main body of the picture information. Now let's have a look of the vestigial sideband diagram. So now in the diagram we can see that here the full USB, that is complete upper sideband, along with small portion of the lower sideband is present, and that is called as vestigial sideband. Now from the entire lower sideband, the part of the LSB is get removed by using a filter. So here also we can say that a frequencies up to 0.75 are get radiated by using an antenna. Now here we can also see that the total channel width is of 7 megahertz. Out of that, 5.5 megahertz is provided for the full USB, which includes guard edge, and it also includes the attenuation slope at both the end. The attenuation slope having value of 0.5 megahertz, because in case of vestigial sideband or in case of video signal transmission, it is difficult to design a filter for suppressing some part or for suppressing full LSB. So in that case, it is not possible to terminate the bandwidth suddenly. Therefore, to avoid this, an attenuation slope is provided at both end of the vestigial sideband, and it is having value of 0.5 megahertz. So we can say that here the 0.5 megahertz slope, attenuation slope is present, and guard edge is also present in case of vestigial sideband. So out of the total channel width of 7 megahertz, 5.5 megahertz is nothing but full USB, which includes 0.5 megahertz attenuation slope, and LSB having a width of 1.25 megahertz. So the frequencies up to 0.75 megahertz are radiated by using the antenna. So here also it is mentioned that because of the difficult filter design, it is not possible to terminate bandwidth of the signal suddenly at the edges of sideband. And because of that, attenuation slope concept comes into picture. So attenuation slope having a maximum or approximate value of 0.5 megahertz. So any distortion at the higher frequency end, if attenuation slope were not allowed, then results into the loss of horizontal details. As high frequency components of the video modulation determines the amount of horizontal details in the picture. So if the attenuation slope is not present, then it may possible that the horizontal components are get loose or the horizontal component may get damaged, and because of that the produced picture quality becomes damaged. So this is what about the vestigial sideband transmission or the vestigial sideband, which consists of full USB along with that some part of the LSB which is not get suppressed and the carrier frequency. The vestigial sideband comes into the picture because it is not possible to suppress one complete lower sideband, because the low frequency component in the video signal carries important information about the video, and if we suppress it, then the information may get lost and results into the damaged picture on the screen. So this is what about the vestigial sideband. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.